Hello, welcome to this presentation in which I will describe a method how to mitigate risk through the use of insect identification tools and augmented reality software. My name is Jörg Rapp. Since April 2013, I'm a PhD student in the working group of mathematical modeling at the University of Koblenz-Landau, Campus Landau. My PhD thesis deals with maps about the temporal and spatial distribution of human diseases and the exposure to pesticides in developing countries. This talk is structured in six parts. At the beginning, I will explain why I want to present this method. In the next part, I will talk about the aims which shall be achieved with this method. Then, I will shortly describe the method itself used to mitigate a risk. In the next part, I will talk about the limitations of this method. And at last, I will show the results and I will give a short conclusion. In tropical and subtropical regions, we can find a high biodiversity. Especially the group of insects are the most diverse group of animals on the planet, including more than 1 million described species and representing more than half of all known living organisms. Thus, a local farmer is confronted very often with insects, e.g. butterflies and caterpillars, ants, termites, and other insects. Dependent on the behavior of the organism, an insect can be a pest in the agricultural process, like locusts, a vector for diseases, like the Anopheles mosquito for malaria, or as a beneficial, like the larvae of some beetles. Let's imagine the following situation. A farmer detects an insect on his field. To know if countermeasures are necessary, it is important for him to know to which group the insect belongs to. It might be a pest, a vector, or beneficial. Dependent on the function of the insect, it might be necessary to fight the pest, or to be aware of vector-transmitted diseases, or to do nothing, and to be glad about having a beneficial on his field. For the farmer, it is important to know to which species the insect belongs to initiate appropriate countermeasures if necessary. Now to the aim, what we want to achieve with this method. We want to combine existing software tools with which it is possible for a local farmer to identify to which species an insect belongs to. In the next step, the farmer shall be informed about if the insect is a pest, a vector, or beneficial, and about countermeasures if necessary. One aim is also to visualize the risk at the current location, e.g. the risk to get malaria or to get exposed to pesticides. Another aim might be to sample data about the presence of species acting as a pest or a vector, and thus to generate distribution maps, and in a further step also risk maps. Now to the methods and how we want to realize such a software system. One aim of our working group is to develop low-cost strategies for risk mitigation. Thus, the used software must be free of charge, like software under open source license or free software. Thus, the farmer don't have to pay for the usage of the software. It shall be possible to identify the species of an insect. There are two ways to identify an insect through the usage of software. The first method is the automated identification with a software tool. A picture of the insect's wing and the wing structure is analyzed. A second method is the classical method to determine the genus of the insect, with an identification key as a software tool. After identification of the insect, the user should be delivered with information and advices about the risk and should be supported, e.g. about countermeasures, or the location of healthcare facilities. This can be realized through the usage of augmented reality software, like the app Mixare, which I want to describe in one of the following slides. The identification of an insect by a software can be performed with two methods. The left picture on the slide shows a method how the genus of an insect can be determined through the characteristics of the insect's wing. First, a picture of the wing has to be taken. A tool like the software Drawing analyzes the connections of the veins of the wing, which is characteristic for each species. Thus, it is possible to determine the species. One disadvantage of this method is that the insect has to be killed. Another method is to identify the insect with an identification key by hand. On the right side, you can see an example of an identification key released as a software tool. The user has to answer questions about the morphology of the insect. After answering the last question, he gets information about the species. Another software used for this approach is an augmented reality software. Augmented reality means that a picture of the real world is enriched with information. The picture on this slide shows an example of an augmented reality software called Mixare. You can view on a specific area through your smartphone, and Mixare shows the location of defined points of interest. In this example, the user is in the Alps and has defined that Mixare shall show the locations of different mountains in the area. In Mixare, it is also possible to use your own database, like the locations of healthcare facilities or insect repellent stores. Mixare is released under open source license. Thus, the source of the software is available for the public and a modification of the software is possible. E.g., it might be helpful for the user to integrate a tool that the background of the display is colored in a way that the user is informed about the current risk. On this slide, a scheme of such a system is shown. First, the insect is identified. In the next step, the user gets information about the insect, e.g. if it's a pest or a vector. This information is stored in a database. If the insect is a pest, the user gets information about possible agents or methods to fight the pest. This advice can be tailored to the user. E.g. for a farmer with biological farming management, it is inappropriate to give him the advice to use a pesticide. It might be also useful for the farmer to have information about the amount he has to applicate, of the best time point, and also information about existing hazards to non-target organisms like humans or beneficials. To determine the best time point for the application, it is useful to integrate data about the weather. In the next step, the augmented reality software shows the user the locations where they have access to agents against the pest or where they can buy protective clothing. If the insect is a vector for diseases, the user gets information about the disease and about possible countermeasures. In this case, the augmented reality software shows the user the location of healthcare facilities or where the user can get access to repellents or mosquito nets. If the insect is a beneficial, the user gets information about the beneficial aspects, like where the insect can help in the agricultural process. This is a part of environmental education. The farmer learns that the presence of an insect on his field doesn't necessarily implicate the usage of pesticides. There are different limitations for this method. Especially in developing countries, databases with the location of healthcare facilities are not available or only with low accuracy. To have access to the different databases, a mobile internet connection is necessary, or space on the mobile device is needed, where the databases can be stored. But the access to mobile internet is limited, especially in developing countries. Another limitation of this method is the fact that the software to determine insects is not available for all species. E.g., the software Drawing was originally developed to determine different species of bees, and is now extended to other species. but not all species are implemented. The same fact can be recognized for software tools to determine the genus by hand. Also, for the automated identification, high-quality pictures with a set of requirements for the background and the brightness are needed. The cameras in newer smartphones meet the necessary requirements. Until such newer smartphones are common in developing countries, it will take some time. The identification by hand needs a little bit training and also equipment. E.g., in the most identification keys, the morphological characteristics have Latin names. It takes a little bit time to get familiar with these names. For small insects, also sometimes a magnifying glass is needed. To deliver information about measures to be taken tailored to the user, a user profile is needed. E.g., if the user has used pesticides in the past. Such profiles have to be created, e.g. by answering a questionnaire prior to the usage of the mentioned software tools. Now to the results. We have demonstrated a method how, through the combination of low-cost software tools, risk mitigation can be achieved. The user needs a mobile device with a temporary internet connection and with an integrated camera. The farmer gets information about the insect and about which measures have to be taken. Biological agents against the pest or pesticides are only applied when necessary, with an adequate application rate and agent. The farmer gets also information about how to prepare the agents, where to buy protective clothing, and so on. Thus, the risk for human health through pesticides can be mitigated. If the pest is a vector for disease, the user gets information that the insect can transmit a disease, as well as information about the disease and possible countermeasures, like to use repellents or mosquito nets and where to buy them. Besides these aspects, the user is educated in environmental issues. The mentioned method shows the application of low-cost risk mitigation software tools. They are free of charge and also usable by people with a low monetary budget. The farmer get trained in the case of having insects on the field, and they are also educated in environmental problems. Through the identification of the insects in combination with temporal and spatial data, it is possible to create distribution maps of the insects, which can be helpful tools to model the presence in the future. Further steps needed to improve this method are the implementation of more species in the identification tools, the visualization of the actual risk in the augmented reality software, e.g. with a background color, and to create spatial databases where the locations of healthcare facilities are stored. Thank you for your attention. If there are any questions, you can ask them in the following flash meeting, or you can also write me an email to rapp@uni-landau.de. Thank you.